Yo, what's up guys, Netscope here, and welcome in the second Spigot plugin tutorial. So today we're gonna get a more in-depth look in chat colors. So first thing we're gonna do is just rename our project. You can do that by right clicking your project, click refactor and rename. So I just used my old project from the first tutorial for this. So we just want to do one thing, and that's create a new void or method. I'm gonna make it a private void chat format, and we only have to do string message in it. Let's do MSG. Here we go. Okay, so private string, I believe. Yes, no private chat color. Okay, so we make it private because we only have to use it in this project. If we have to use it in only one package, make it protected. If we can use it everywhere, make it public. So we can private. Now let's just make it public, maybe for later. So we're gonna want to return something, and that is chat color dot translate alternate color codes. Then you want to make a char, which is only one. How you call this? I don't know the word for it, but it's not the double one, but it's the single one. And you want to make the N sign like this, and you want to translate the message MSG. So yeah, it's string, not chat color. I'm sorry, I didn't remember it correctly. So now you have this. So we have the method chat format, and that's basically what we want. So we do chat format. So like this. Okay. And yes, that's basically what we want. Chat format, and then this between the costs. And yeah, now it's still white, but now we can do like N, C for red, and A for green, and B for aqua. So it's much easier. You don't have to do paragraph B, you don't have to do chat color dot aqua, you can just do NB. So yeah, that's basically what we added this project, this tutorial. There's not much to explain. Let me just explain this. A public string returns a string, so it returns a text which you wanna have. So it returns chat color dot translate alternate color codes and in message. So it basically just returns this message, but it replaces the N sign with chat color codes. So now we have this method or string which we can do here on our message. So we're gonna wanna export our project and go onto the server, and let me switch it to Minecraft. Here we go. I'm gonna reload the server, gonna join it. Oops, wrong one. Here we are in our world. So if we do slash hello now, as you can see, I get it in aqua. So if we're gonna change it to another color of choice, here we go, let's change it to NA. So we're gonna reload the server, and I'm gonna change it to Minecraft again. And if we do hello, I forgot to export the project. Slash reload, slash hello. Hello back, we get in green. What you can also do is, if we go to Eclipse back, you can also do, for example, let's say a backslash, which is not possible, of course. This sign, or maybe even this sign. No, that's not possible. You can do everything you want, maybe even dot. If you say dot C now, I believe this should work. Never tried it, but because I always do it with N. So if we do slash hello now, as you can see, we get hello back in red. So you can replace it with everything of your choice. I'd recommend an N sign. Oh, sorry, I forgot to change it to my Minecraft. Here we go. Let's do it again. Hello. As you can see, it works. So, yeah. I just recommend to change it back to N, like this. And, yeah, that's the best you can do. So, N, B, let's make it aqua. So, yeah, that's basically it for this tutorial. It's not that extensive. If you know, it's not too long, it's just a simple thing you can learn, and yeah, it's pretty easy. Try something out with it, just do some experimenting before you see my next tutorial. Maybe you can even join my server and check it out, or not my server but my friend's server. I'm developer on it, and yeah, thanks for watching. Please leave a like if you learned from it, and go come back for my next tutorial. And yeah, thanks for watching. See you guys.